Welcome back to Let's Play Cyberpunk 2077 Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Yeah, we're gonna drive this thing. We can finally go help Panam. Well, I thought I was gonna drive this thing. I actually turned it. Couldn't back up. Oh wait, no, it is this way. Oh, that gun I don't want. With a little help from my friends, going to the Aldecaldo camp. How far away is this? Okay. I have to make a left coming up. Oh no, right. Oh, left. Well, it makes you feel better. Now they have a kind of like invisible force field in there. So yeah, I can't go anymore. Reporting directly to me. We're preparing. Let's try this again. Okay.
No. The rest will stay here in camp. I want patrols every half hour. Reporting directly to me.
Bossy.
Are we preparing for a visit from Biotechnica? Or a fourth corporate war?
The Raffens could surprise us at any moment.
You're not blowing this a little out of proportion.
I don't want any more surprises.
Let me in.
Besides, we look good, aware, prepared.
The guy won't let me in. Will you move? So not getting in there.
Piss off!
Beg your pardon? Oh. What'd you say? Oh.
Fire and Mike.
We can get in this way.
V, hi. You're here.
Yeah, I couldn't get in.
What is she doing here?
I'm supposed
I forbade
to
you from even breathing on that Militech convoy, so you call in your friend? To do it all behind my back? Is that it?
We're right in front of you.
That's exactly why I had V come and stand right
forbade
in front of you.
Forbade Panam from doing something?
You really think you can forbid Panam from doing anything?
All right.
Trust me, really no point. She'll do whatever she wants.
No, she won't. Not if she plans to stay in this family.
Damn it to hell, Saul. Are you seriously considering letting that basilisk slip through our fingers?
I am.
Oh, the basilisk?
But a chance like this.
A chance at what? Rotting up the job we came here to do?
Get the sense this fight's grown stale. Come on, put some feeling into it.
No. This discussion ended long ago. The Biotechnica people will be here in an hour. Try not to cock anything else up before then.
Sounds like the discussion's still going on.
I can't believe it. Look, there he goes, off to paint the grass green.
I thought the Biotechnica job was a bust.
Thought the Biotechnica contract had withered and died.
Saul insists we see it through to the end. To prove the Aldecaldos keep their word.
Crop protection. Who gives a damn about crop protection? All Saul is going to prove is that a corp can walk all over us, and we'll say thank you and ask for more.
Well, now I can't say she's been quiet. What's this about a basilisk? It does sound familiar.
What's this basilisk nonsense?
It's an armored Militech cargo panzer. Junk from back in 2060 or so. They want to peddle it off to a backwards country, somewhere it can still pass as a technological wonder.
The Militech convoy will take the 101 right past us. Shame not to say hello.
Let me guess, this is your idea?
Let me guess, whole thing's your idea?
How did you know?
Saul wouldn't be quite so pissed if it weren't.
Look at that look.
I believe V is right. If this had been Saul's idea, he would have seen it as the greatest plan on God's green earth.
Oh, Saul isn't that petty. He's simply a coward. He would rather play it safe, bide his time. For the family.
So is the basilisk worth having a fight with Saul?
This basilisk worth another fight with Saul?
Yes, a craft like that would finally put us back on the right path.
Family is falling apart. If we fall into this biotechnica rut, no one will ever take us seriously again.
Okay, so you do want to go behind Saul's back. Dragged me here specifically for that.
Cassidy, Ted, Carol, and Bob also on board.
What is Saul's problem with the basilisk anyway?
Why has Saul got his briefs in a bunch over this basilisk?
He's afraid Militech will destroy us if we pick a fight with it.
He thinks it's safer to stick with the corporations, like Biotechnica. What a joke.
And you guys would rather...
We would rather go back to plying the trade we know best. Logistics.
Meaning smuggling.
That's what I said.
No, it's not. I thought you and Saul were getting along now.
Thought you and Saul had agreed to bury your carbines.
So did I. But it seems that's only true when somebody is trying to kill us.
Exactly. Yeah. You saved his life. You want to fuck things up all over again now?
I saved his life, yet somehow he still ignores everything I say. So I do believe we have come full circle.
Yeah, I'm not gonna say this. I'll go with her plan. What's the plan?
What's gotten into you?
I'm just thinking. I'm wondering what the plan is.
And you plan to grab the basilisk, how?
Thanks, V.
Haven't said I'd help just yet.
Okay, let's go talk to the rest.
Just a question. Alright, now we're talking to the rest. Oh, he lets you buy. Just the vets on board here?
So, just the four vets on board with the plan. Nobody else.
We didn't bother asking the others.
There was too great a risk someone would take it to Saul.
Besides, only the vets understand what we have to gain by having a basilisk.
Sounds pretty risky, though.
Sounds pretty risky to me.
On the contrary, easy as pie. There won't even be much security on the convoy. Plus, we'll be doing our part towards furthering the cause of world peace.
I don't believe that part about minimal security.
Why should this piece wind up being used in some little third world skirmish?
Why not?
We'll make better use.
Did you try to get Saul on board again? No luck, huh?
No. Okay, everyone listen. Militech will transport the basilisk in parts distributed across two trucks.
Wait, do I sense a quiver in your voice?
Fuck you! The convoy will halt at the railroad crossing on the 101. We'll attack from behind, then get the hell out and away. Questions? Comments? Motions?
Nice job, Sunshine.
Mm-hmm. Damn short, sweet, and pertinent.
Panam's got a beef
None
with Saul.
That sad sack bullshit Saul likes to tack on.
You guys?
Panam's got a beef with Saul. I know, but you guys?
A few years back, nobody would have given corporal work a second thought.
We want a good name. We just need good gear and good jobs.
Cassidy.
And Saul would see that if he pulled his head out of his caboose once in a while.
So we got you four. You're Cassidy. I forget his name already. And then you two.
V?
Unknown. Alright, I'm in.
Okay. I'm in.
Okay. Thanks. First, we'll ride to the station. The train engine we need to block the convoy's way is there. Are you riding with us, or will we meet you there?
I'm riding with.
Riding with you.
Excellent. Let's get going.
I enjoy our little drives.
I think I heard a little shake in that voice.
You did not.
Come on. Did you get your hands clammy, too?
Screw you. Well,
but
B?
Are you sure you didn't leave any tracks? Militech won't know this thing.
Are you trying to insult me, Bobby?
Okay. Forget I even asked.
Oh, we're playing over this.
Whatever, asshole. And to you.
Keep the chatter to a minimum. Don't hit anything.
Let's go.
Yep, yeah, why'd you stop? Okay. So no one at camp is gonna notice that you're gone, like Saul?
Nobody's gonna notice you gone back at camp?
Saul has no wish to see us there anyway. The better to make a good second impression on the Biotechnica suit.
Your sour faces wouldn't help much.
Indeed, they would not.
Are you expecting any trouble from Raffens?
And the Raffens, what about them? Expecting any trouble?
Saul is. He's posted sentries all around the camp.
How is that not right?
He's wrong in continuing to fight the symptoms rather than the disease.
You don't miss Night City at all?
Don't miss life in Night City?
At times, perhaps. I miss the feeling of having a new beginning. Of freedom. But I also haven't forgotten the emptiness. The feeling of realizing it means nothing if you're alone.
Yeah, it took some adjustment for me, too.
Yeah. Took adjustment on my part, too. Though, never was completely alone.
True that.
You had someone?
A true friend. Jackie by name.
I was thinking it's Johnny Silverhand.
Jackie. I'll remember that.
There's a Johnny now. We're never alone.
We have arrived.
Yeah, let's see about this no security or almost no security.
Big bastard.
If you like it so much, maybe we should just hijack the train.
We've been here.
Let the basilisk go on its way.
Yeah, then just drive this beast to the 101. There and back.
Saul would be on board with that.
Are we ready? Okay, the Militech convoy will be traveling from Night City to the base where they're due to meet the buyer. We will stop it at the railroad crossing.
All we have to do is shove this beauty in its way.
Mitch.
V, any Cassidy. Questions?
Yeah, who are those people? Who are these people? How do we plan to move the engine?
Plan to move this thing how exactly?
It's old tech. Carol will have to hack it.
Carol?
And I'll somehow have to finagle authorization from the control tower to move it.
Tower looks inactive to me, too.
Yeah, we'll see to that. You and Panam just get the authorization code.
Okay, let's get to work.
I've been up here before. I think this is the one I was in.
My, that was quick.
Yeah, my technical ability. Aren't you impressed?
As it is, then.
Talk to the nomad.
Do you need a light?
Well done. Thanks, boys.
Oh, they're up there already? What am I sneaking for? They're up here already? Are they?
I've always been fond of trains. And the stations where so many tracks converge.
Junctions.
Yes. Quick feet, come on.
Free? Like you could set off on 1,000 journeys all at once?
Perhaps more simply, hopeful.
So if I jump out here, we can talk to them. Yeah, I'll be right there. Yeah. Talk to them. What you doing, Cassidy? Well, wait, that's Cassidy? Wait.
Read the opening line. You know you're in for a lovely 1,000-page ride.
You're Cassidy.
I mean...
What are you two doing?
Oh, sorry, I interrupted.
I'm finding my inner peace before the storm. While Teddy is just being dead weight.
Well, I'm happy to join you in your little quest.
Love to join you.
Respect your efforts. Self-respect breeds self-discipline. Once you have both, you have real power.
A goal, a love, and a dream give you total control.
A goal, a love, and a dream are what breed a real man.
That's not what I want to
say. Sure word, sister.
You always wax philosophical when you drink?
Drink and always breed deep thoughts?
I just feel like people expect some motivational bullshit from me.
All right, you two have fun then.
Have fun, kids.
I'm gonna say Panam's gonna pay. So you're Teddy, and then Carol over here.
Well, hello there. Have you come to make yourself useful?
Do you know how to use legacy tech like this?
Never seen old tech like this. Know your way around it. How'd you learn?
From books? Just wait till you see what's inside the signal tower. They use punch cards. Punch cards! Can you believe it?
I did see that. What kind of cards?
What cards now?
An old data storage method. When the net collapsed, we were thrown back to the 20th century.
Oh,
what's
kidding.
It even look like?
They're cardboard cards with holes punched in them, as code in columns.
That's harsh.
Each hole position, punched or not, represents a unit of data.
That's crazy. You guys had to go back to punch cards? I mean, that's worse.
Hello?
That's worse than dial-up. Alright, well, I want to talk about Panam. Not sure about what, but...
Honestly, prefer Panam to punch cards as a topic of conversation.
Let me guess. You don't really know why you're here, do you?
Panam asked for help. I'm getting this thing.
Panam asked me for help.
She came back to the fold, sweet-talked Mitch and the rest over to her side. But still, she calls you. Interesting, isn't it?
Alright. Guess I'm done talking. There's, one member, though, that I haven't talked to. Well, there's more. I don't remember you guys. Who are they? Can't force it. Should I open this door from the other side in case we need to make a getaway or something? Is it here? Oh, I can't. I need to force it from that side too. Oh, well, at least we have something here. 6:30 arrows, hey. Alright, Panam, I'm coming. We're gonna go check out these punch cards together. Isn't that exciting? Hi. I save mostly because
okay,
crashes.
Here we are.
Mostly. Punch cards.
Punch cards.
Told ya.
What cards?
Punch cards.
Cards punched with a bunch of holes. Let me help look.
Okay. Thank you.
Nothing here.
Oh, file cabinet. Documents and archival notes. Wait, that continues on.
Not a...
Okay, it must be here somewhere.
V, look thoroughly, please.
I'm looking thoroughly. Pretty sure it was on one of these desks.
Not a...
That's where I saw him. Maybe they're upstairs. What's that? There's a thingy.
Some sort of Stone Age control panel.
Locomotive controls. A type of control in which the output of one controller is the set point for another. Recompilation required. Right, I've read this before. You guys want to read this again? Pause the video. Shutting everything down. All right, how do we do this again? Yeah. The old way.
Nothing here.
Cardboard box.
Well, well, well.
Gotcha. Do I need any more? I mean, you can't fit much information at all on a punch card. Where is she? Over here? Ah, found it.
Got something.
Good job.
Thanks.
Carol! We have a card! What now?
Put in the machine.
You have to put it in the reader!
Could have told
well,
you that.
The card. In the reader?
Yep. I will put it in the reader. Where's the reader again? Oh, yeah. Here goes.
Here goes nothing.
Gotta love my nails. Just gotta. Not optional.
It worked! Come look!
Oh. Where are we looking? I'm going the wrong way. I'm getting all excited here. Oh, here's John.
Little engine that could.
Oh, yeah, there it goes.
V, I wanted to speak with you.
Okay. At least we're alone again, sort of. What do you want to talk about?
What do you want to talk about?
I know this may sound foolish, because I asked you to help me. But...
You want me to leave now?
Why are you doing this?
Oh. What? Trust issues again?
Trust issues again. I thought we talked it all out.
V, I know I can count on you,
but...
Let's come back.
But... No one has ever done something like this for me before. Not without a catch.
Well... Meaning nobody from outside the family.
Meaning nobody from outside the fam.
Yes. We could both stand and think about what that means. All right. Let's rejoin the others.
Okay. That was a... Short conversation.
Ah, shit!
Convoy, got eyes and ears on it?
Yes, Carol checks their communication channels from time to time. Everything is proceeding as planned. For now.
Wait, just bear with me now. I'm getting some... stuff going on. Join the nomads at the junction. I'll just follow you. Saul says, V, do you know where Panam is? Not her babysitter. For crying out loud, I don't care what's going on between you two. I'm just asking. Can't give me a straight answer? When you see her, tell her I'm looking for her. Maybe. I'm seeing her now. But yet, I'm not saying crap, am I? Dude, there was something for me to examine. Oh. What are they doing? Playing music out here? You guys stop clowning around.
And breathe.
Everything's under control. The convoy is already heading our way.
Bob. So it is more than four of them. Can I sit down too? You worried about Saul?
Worried about Saul.
Talk to
the
veterans.
You're acting spooked. As if you're the first person ever to stand up to Saul. Oh, save your breath. I don't need to be consoled.
So what's this say? The Great Nomad Saga continues. Panam's up to something. That girl just says no when to quit. And my god, I love her for it. You don't seem to know either, considering you want to go back out there. Maybe you could save us all some time, pitch a tent out in the desert? I think we both know this isn't just about the job anymore. Okay. So you go right into... Yeah, that's cool. You gotta read through all this stuff soon. Oh, by the way, as of this episode, we're in version 1.31.
Was it someone I know?
New. Scorpion.
You came home from the war, head full of new ideas, and a host of new contacts.
He tried to get Saul to lead us in joining Snake Nation. It would make us stronger, he said.
I don't think he peeped a word of it to me. What did Saul do?
Saul dressed the guy down head to toe for messing with the family. Hell, he didn't send him on any jobs for a year.
Gee, really consoling. Thanks.
You said yourself you didn't need any.
Let's drink to Scorpion.
Gonna try and get some sleep.
Wait.
Okay. It'll be quite some time before the convoy comes
through. Not what I tried to say. Alright, well, I can tell you won't be getting any sleep then.
Couldn't sleep if you tried, could you?
Did you just doze off?
I did. I dozed off.
I'll just lie here a while. Fireside, gazing at the stars.
Aww.
That another area of your expertise? Got maps of the heavens in your library, too?
Of course. That's the Big Dipper. And do you see the small flickering star to the right?
To the right. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah?
You do? Oh, dear. That means there's a major leak.
Very funny.
Good night, B.
I was gonna toast him. I don't know what happened.
Okay, here they come.
Is everyone ready?
No way. Hold up. All right,
let's ride, V.
Get up. Oh, how'd I get on that thing? Dakota Smith. Hello, V. By a stroke of fate, a quartz bandit has landed in my lap. The city boy who bought her must have thought he would rule the streets, but his abilities behind the wheel proved just the opposite. He bet her on his first race and ended up walking home by foot. Now she belongs to me. Don't let appearances fool you. Some claim there's no faster machine suited to the Badlands. In the right hands, of course. Legend has it that the one and only Billy Bandit McCarty worked on this model, with Archer releasing only a handful of units onto the market. I've sent you her coordinates. It would be a shame not to seize this opportunity. Now I'm going to be seizing it for a while. What I'm wondering is when this mission is done, if it's going to be opening up more assaults in progress and crap. I mean, so far nothing. I worked hard clearing out these Badlands. So, I mean, if it's still cleared out, we can just go back to the city and start clearing out all that crap. What's that look for? I can't save right now. Well, hopefully I don't crash right now. I could save before when we were driving. Nope.
Alright. She's moving.
Get her up to speed.
I'm trying to save, no? That thing's moving out. Careful.
They're going faster than we thought. I don't know if we can catch them.
Uncouple one of the cars. It'll speed you up. V, no hemming and hawing. Take out that coupler.
What are we doing? What are we doing?
We're getting close. This is slow.
What am I doing?
Shoot out the damn coupler.
Shoot the coupler? Oh. Oh, wrong thing.
We have to run the car!
So, we want to speed this thing up? Isn't it going too fast already?
Okay. Come on, they're all yours, boys.
Move that ass, Teddy boy.
Am I just going to shoot these guys?
No, five vehicles! No, walk! We need a new route!
Can I just blow up these cars?
Hurry up!
Don't you worry. We're almost
home
now.
Fuck me!
It's jammed. Alright, I'm getting out. Whoa! Can't affect that. Is that our friend?
Mitch, Bob, go!
All is planned, boss.
All right, the train's leaving.
What are you doing? He's chasing this stuff around. Probably supposed to hurry up because the thing's leaving. We'll catch it. Don't worry. In midair. That's a good trick. It's the boots. The boots weighed me down. I'm not carrying that much. Everything. Almost. Can't get it. I could have run up here and sniped them.
Okay, let's go!
Ready to roll.
Thanks for waiting for me. Yo, out of the way. Can't save again. The trucks to the Nomad camp.
How's it going there, V? Did you have fun?
Sure did.
Yeah.
Just be happy you won't be around to put the hunk of junk together. The real fun is just starting for Mitch and Teddy.
If you say so. Can't be that easy. Gotta be something else gonna happen.
Okay, I just lost the Militech channel.
Hmm?
The Zoots finally realized someone was listening and changed the codes.
That means they're up to something.
Perfect timing if you ask me.
Can't save? Nope. Means they're using the channel to coordinate an attack against us. We're gonna have to defend the Aldecaldo camp.
I can talk to him if you want.
No, thank you. I'll take care of this myself.
I'm coming with you. Where is he? There he is, 25
Fuck,
meters away.
So it begins.
Yep. This guy's got such a chip on his shoulder about everything.
What's the meaning of this?
Exactly what you see. The Basilisk.
All I see is two trucks with giant Militech logos on them. Fuck, Panam! You can see them from miles away! You think we don't have problems enough on our hands? The Raffens could rear their heads at any moment. And now we have Militech to worry about, too.
Stop it! Fuck! Just shut up already! Do you want to serve corporations forever? Fine, go right ahead. In that case, we'll leave the basilisk as a souvenir of what this family used to be. Or you know what? Maybe next time we're attacked, we'll be able to fight back!
As soon as I'm done with Biotechnica, we call a family meeting to discuss this. Discuss you. Until that time, I want these trucks out of my sight.
And the basilisk? Can we put it together?
Do what you want. Just get out of my sight.
You
Bob,
get...
Mitch, you two take the trucks around back. We need to unload.
Sure, but then what do we do with them?
Oh, I've got an idea.
Some lungs you got there. He should get out of our sight, though.
Got quite a pair of lungs there.
Thanks. I believe the last time I pulled something like that, I was 10 years old.
Huh. Seems still to be in fine working order.
Everything all right?
Everything okay?
Yes, of course. Though the great train robbery bit of this was much more enjoyable.
All right, well, you need me again, let me know.
You need me again. All you gotta do is call.
V, I'm sure I will. So you'd better expect that call.
Be waiting. Take care.
We're done already? Okay, I guess so. Job complete. Out over here. The wall. Another brick in the wall. Who's leaving this money out here? Oh, and I can't even get it though. Ugh. Illusionary money. I can't take any of these cars. Oh, I can apparently take this one. So it still looks clear. Doesn't look like anything's been added as far as new quests and assault in progress and all that stuff. Oh wait, what's this? No, there is one thing here. That's it? Apparently that's it. There's one side job. Undiscovered. Moderate. Okay. We'll be doing that next episode, and then probably after that, returning to the city, unless Panam calls us again or something. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always seek adventure.